cheeky little Kalo Navas to start things off with.
There once was a cheeky Navas BC Neps, gonna pop him into the Nani Totses tomorrow, which basically means this card is going into an SBC. Oh, when the cheeky man comes, Neps gonna say,
pop him in Nani.
Oh, when the cheeky man comes, Neps also gonna say,
oh, Kalo Navas, I'll take him.
What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome to a cheeky Kalo Navas. Navas. What's up, guys? Nepenthes here, and welcome to a cheeky Kalo Navas. I pop him right into the Nani SBC. What's up, boys? And welcome to the cheeky Kalo Navas. That's right, you pop him into the Nani SBC Episodia, the meme made popular courtesy of the one, the only, the FIFA god, the FIFA goat, Nepenthes. Today, boys, we see ourselves get a 91 cheeky Kalo Navas. Looks like he's going for about 115, 120,000 coins. If you guys have a PSG side, there's something weird going on with the top of this card design. Is there something broken on the card? Wait, the card design's broken on the top. Neither here nor there. The rolling thing, the only thing we really care today about is what the hell are we going to do with Team of the Season, which starts tomorrow. And I think one of the things that you could do with this cheeky Kalo Navas is slowly craft him as we get those upgrade packs, as you have that fodder. Again, 110,000 coins for a 91 rated card. You could do a whole lot worse in terms of fodder. If you're a PSG supporter, if you did the Care SBC, if you guys have a Ligue 1 squad, obviously Navas is a guy that you could possibly get into your squad. But then again, you could just probably buy whatever the 89 or 90 rated UCL version is off the market. There probably isn't going to be any gameplay in today's episode here, just because I think today is kind of just like a menu grind, you know what I mean? So we've got this cheeky Kalo Navas, looks like a pretty good card. 6-1, 1-star skill moves, 3-star weak foot, hella underrated in real life, 89 positioning, 94 goalkeeper reflexes, everything looks pretty damn decent. So we're going to send him over to the club. I think the Kalo Navas is definitely something that you try to put together in terms of your fodder plan for Team of the Season. I'd kind of be surprised if people didn't run it like this, but I think most people are probably realistically going to run something like this. And even with this, you guys are you're probably chilling, and that's all you need for links, right? So you get two PSG links into Care, and then you get obviously the Karzawa green link into him. You got no one, and then you also have yourselves a cheeky McLaren. So that looks kind of cool. Again, not going to do any gameplay today. We're not going to test it out, but that is a fun trio of players that you can link in. If you guys are hyped for Team of the Season, smash like on the video. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. If you guys are tossing your 91 cheeky Kalo Navas into an SBC or plan to at some point during Team of the Season, smash like on the video. But anyway, boys, cool little link right here. Like I said, Care, Lavion Karzawa, and then freaking... and then a cheeky Kalo Navas. Looks pretty cool. Three different card types. Obviously, the green links. Now, if we go over to squad building challenges, we got some new SBCs today. We got this... what do we got? We got an 84 plus upgrade pack. Now, let me... Your regularly scheduled program needs to be interrupted by arguably one of the most important PSAs going into Team of the Season, which starts tomorrow. Okay? Roll it.
What is something you found out late in life that you should have known earlier, but you just didn't?
That premature epaculation is a very real and very serious medical concern affecting millions of Ultimate Team players each and every year. According to the official FIFA Medical Journal, premature epaculation is defined as the inability to save sick packs that you grinded through objectives or rewards and not able to save them for a sweet Friday promo. Side effects of premature epaculation include crippling diarrhea, no money in your bank account, excess fodder, and the inability not to pack this guy in every one of your 50k packs. If you get sick easily, I warn you, look away.
Don't get it twisted, boys. Premature epaculation is a serious medical condition affecting many FIFA Ultimate Teamers each and every year. You have to be strong, boys. You have to literally, you know, if you're waiting for your Team of the Season release, then I think now would be as good of time as any to kind of show you guys that aren't used to a Team of the Season release what to expect. So tomorrow, being the 23rd, we are expecting Community Team of the Season and EFL Team of the Season. That will be available for a week. If we're basing it on last year's schedule, by the way, shout out this guy, HDDH96, who put this together over on the FIFA Reddit. Premier League will come a week later. Saudi League will come a couple days after that. La Liga Santander will be on the 7th, and then a couple days after that, another minor league. So basically, the way it works is a big league comes out, and then a small league comes out shortly after that. And that's what you can expect in terms of at least the content plan, at least as it was last week. So we have about a month and a half or so of Team of the Season content. Guaranteed Team of the Season SBC. Now, a lot of you guys are wondering possibly what to do with your fodder. The last year, there were two guaranteed TOTS SBCs released every week, one for the Major League and one for the Minor League in packs. Once we see the pattern of releasing these SBCs in the first week, this section will be updated accordingly. So this is a thread on Reddit that the guy's going to update it. So basically what happens on a guaranteed Team of the Season SBC from the Minor League was released on a Monday, and then a guaranteed Team of the Season SBC from a big league released on a Friday. So we can generally expect those two things to happen. So, for example, EFL, the community TOTS is going to get themselves most likely a guaranteed SBC, and then maybe EFL, and then the EFL is going to get themselves a guaranteed SBC. The only other thing I could think of is that they release two SBCs containing all 30 of the players, which would be interesting. But if we're looking at the traditional route, two times a week we get ourselves a guaranteed Team of the Season SBC. One's for the big league, one is for the small league. Weekend league rewards. So the one thing that you need to know is Gold 2 traditionally has been that thing that you want to hit that guarantees you at least one red player pick from the big Team of the Season release, right? So if La Liga, if Liga Santander and Liga NOS are both available as players in the rewards pick, if you get at least Gold 2, you're guaranteed at least one player from the La Liga Team of the Season release. So the silver, all the silver ones, you're capped at basically how big of a player you can get. Your player pick contains at least one Team of the Season player from a minor league or a big league. You're not guaranteed. Right, so anything between Silver 1 and Gold 3, you're not guaranteed a big league Team of the Season. So you could get, for in the previous example, you could get a La Liga or a Liga NOS one, but you're not guaranteed a big league. You're not guaranteed a La Liga player in your player pick. But Gold 2 or above, you're guaranteed at least one of the big league Team of the Season. So, yeah, I mean, pretty much that's to be expected. We don't know what order this is going to come in, but it's most likely going to be most of these, it's going to be most likely be the most familiar big leagues and then some of the smaller ones. Again, EA are probably going to do things a little bit differently. Speaking of Team of the Season, we had a new splash screen today, and a lot of people are predicting that this 90 rated could be either Ndombele, Digne, Zuma, which I don't think it's going to be Zuma, or possibly Mukiel. Middle one, people, I see everything ranging from Fede Valverde to Chiesa, Federico Chiesa, and then the right back, I think most people are expecting it to be Aaron Wan-Bissaka, which would be a plus 10 dribbling upgrade, which would be kind of mad. But maybe you guys let me know. Maybe that's the question of the episode. What players do you think this three are? I think maybe Digne, Fede, or Chiesa, and then Aaron Wan-Bissaka. I think the easiest one to predict is this Aaron Wan-Bissaka. Also, yeah, Ndombele is one that people are guessing there. Ndombele, Valverde, Wan-Bissaka. I reckon it could be Chiesa. I think he would have 95, 96. I doubt a Piemonte Calcio player headlines community Team of the Season. So, yeah, I don't know. Maybe you guys let me know what you think about that in the comment section below. We got ourselves an 84 rated rare player pick pack, right? So this guarantees you get one out of four rare gold players. It's non-repeatable. So this is not a pack that's, you know, once you pop this, it's over. So you definitely want to hold on to this. I don't know what the requirements are. Let's check that out right now. It's an 83 rated with 40 chemistry, which isn't too bad. And this is the sort of pack, right? For example, let's go back to my previous example. If we know Bundesliga is probably going to come a couple of weeks in, maybe 2 or 3 weeks in, this is a pack and you run basically a full Bundesliga side, this is a pack that you're going to want to save for that, right? So the toughest thing to do is to build all these packs and then save for that promo, save for the league that you really care about. A lot of people, I feel like, are going to suffer premature packulation when a week from tomorrow we get ourselves the Premier League, right? I think most everyone is going to see those crazy, crazy cards, and I don't think anyone's going to have enough self-restraint. They're going to rip those packs. And then, for example, if you're saving for La Liga or Bundesliga, you may fail your premature immaculation challenge. So got yourselves an 84 plus rare player pick. I don't think that's too bad for value. We got ourselves the marquee matchups. And then outside of that, I think that's pretty much it. I would wait for the 81 PP packs. I wouldn't do this 81 plus double upgrade pack. I'd do the 81 PP packs. We got ourselves some new league SBCs as well. You get yourself the Chinese Super League, which if you complete it, I think you get yourselves a 50K pack. Yeah, you get a rare player pack. You get a 50K pack for this. And I think there's a few other ones that came out as well, and you can kind of craft them, and you can try and find some packs within those that might be worth doing. So that's pretty much all I have in terms of what I would recommend to do. Nothing too crazy. Again, if you guys saved some of your icon swaps packs, you guys will have some packs to open during Team of the Season. And if you guys are nearing some of your objectives, which I know on the RTG in terms of milestones, I'm getting close to Rivals Mastery, which means I'm nearing the 300 matches, which
which gets you, sorry, 200 matches, which gets you an ultimate pack. So I'll have that for, hopefully, be able to save it for the Bundesliga team of the season. But again, the Cheeky Kaylor Navas, cool little SBC. Again, not too expensive, about 100,000 coins for a 91 rated card. We also have ourselves that Kostic, who is not a bad idea to grind towards in terms of fodder. And then also we have that Deco. For those of you guys that might have some leftover icon swaps, the 91 Deco is only 7 tokens. So he might be a guy that you would consider doing in terms of players and stuff that you can save for fodder. And again, yeah, not too expensive for an 88 Filip Kostic. Again, you can throw your excess fodder into those and use those for whatever team of the season SBCs come out. And it has been confirmed that there is going to be a team of the season moments, and as confirmed in this little post over here. Where is it? Right here. Team of the season moments confirmed. So for example, if we click that, that's the regular team of the season card, and then the one on the right is obviously team of the season moments, and that's most likely going to be SBC releases that we get every few days, if not maybe every day. But not too crazy of an episode here today, just give you guys my thoughts on team of the season, what I'm doing. Again, I'm going to be waiting for the PP packs to come out. Hopefully they come out tomorrow, and those are going to be little SBCs that are going to be repeatable and that you can grind. And I think those will give you the best chance of packing a blue. And then also just, yeah, Cheeky Kaylor Navas. Gonna throw that 91 into an SBC that requires it. The Deco, remember the Niederlechner and the Asensio. Those are also objectives that you could do. So there's plenty of grindable fodder if you guys are low on coins or at least need something to grind towards. So for example, where are these lads? Yeah, we got the Niederlechner. It took me about an hour and a half to get him last night. And then tonight on stream, we're going to be working on the Asensio. And these aren't too difficult to do. The objectives are pretty straightforward. But that's going to do it for the Episodia, boys. The Cheeky Kaylor Navas Episodia. If you guys did enjoy, smash like on the video. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. Going to be streaming on Twitch later tonight. Going to pop at least my reds and then save the rest of the rewards for a team of the season. And yeah, hopefully this was a little bit helpful. Again, no gameplay today. Just thought I would kind of guide you guys through my team of the season plan, saving definitely going on tradable this week in terms of rewards, because I need the double fodder to be able to do some of those 81 PP packs, assuming we get them, and then just have the fodder to stack up for the SBCs, because that's how we run our account. But you guys let me know what your content plan is for team of the season. If you guys did enjoy the episode, like I said, smash like. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. I'll catch you guys for a stream later tonight. Till next time, my bros, tschüss, later, adieu.